Peter said, spell love. Okay? So she spelled the word love. L-O-V-E. Love. Welcome to heaven, sister. Then, after that, St. Peter asked her if she could take his place for just a moment. He instructed her, if somebody comes up, to follow the same procedure he gave her. So after a few minutes, she sees her ex-husband. And to her surprise, hey, what are you doing here? And then the husband said, well, I had a heart attack. And I think I made it to heaven, didn't I? Not yet. You have to correctly spell a word. She said, what word? He said, and she said, and there was a long pause. And then he said to the husband, spell Czechoslovakia. Something wonderful, something liberating, something empowering happens when you begin to realize that you are unconditionally and deeply loved, totally forgiven, accepted, approved, made righteous. My friends, this is your identity if you are in. So in today's sharing, we're going to need to read all these scriptures to help you discover how God sees you, what you have in Christ, and how you can confidently face all these different challenges that we all have in life. Amen? As a beloved child, as you know who you are in Christ, you can confidently face face those challenges. So let's dive into the Word of God. Okay, the first point is, in Christ, you are loved. Or I am loved. Let's personalize it. Everyone say after me. In Christ,
I am loved.
Okay, let's check what are those scriptures that says that you are loved. Romans 5:8. But God demonstrates his own love towards us in that while we were yet sinning, Christ died for us. 1 John 3:16. By this we know love, because he laid down his life for us, and we also ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. Romans 8:32, one of my favorite. He did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all. How shall he not with him also freely give us all things? And Philippians 4:19, and my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. When we look at our lives and find ourselves wondering if God really loves us, when we go through all these trials and tribulations in our lives, look at the cross and see how God's outstretched arms, ready to receive. What are those concerns that you have? And it will remind and reassure you of how much he loves you. The cross is the symbol of God's love for all of us. It is the cross that God demonstrated his own love towards us, in that while we were still sinning, Christ died for us. And that Romans 8:32, imagine, he did not withheld his own son, but freely delivered him up for all of us all. So think about that. If he did not withhold his only son, will he withhold all those needs that we all will be needing in this life? Think about that. Just imagine, just zero in on that particular scripture, that verse. He did not withheld, he did not spare his own son, but freely gave it up to us. Scripture says, faith comes by hearing, and by hearing the word of God. It doesn't matter how many times you've heard the Bible or the Word of God, but as you hear it, faith comes alive. Just imagine the word, nothing is impossible with God. And here you are facing a trial, facing something. And you hear that word. Isn't it that faith will arise in your spirit? The same thing with all kinds. There's so many scriptures that we can read, we can meditate on. These are just examples. There's so many. And this will prove that you are and I are known, my friends. Amen? Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. So, it's a proof that God loves us. He will take care of all our needs. Amen? Second point, in Christ, I am completely forgiven. Let's read the scriptures. Ephesians 1:7. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace. Romans 4:7-8. Blessed are those whose lowest deeds are forgiven, and those sins whose sins are covered. Blessed is the man to whom the Lord shall not impute sin. Next slide, please. Hebrews 8:12. For
positions that I am not proud of. Of course, there were a lot of consequences, and the guilt and condemnation, I was really struggling. I was blaming myself. There was a time I was blaming God. Everything was just so dark. But when I started reading, learning these scriptures, that I am totally forgiven. In Christ, I have been redeemed through His blood. That He Himself has not remembered my sins. Why will I remember those sins? Why will I keep on meditating on those mistakes that I have done, wherein He said, I will be merciful to you. I will be merciful to your unrighteousness and your sins and your lawless deeds. So upon reading, meditating, as I kept on meditating those scriptures, I was delivered from guilt and condemnation. Do I make mistakes till today? Yes, I do make mistakes. But instead of being sin conscious, I started to become Christ conscious.
Amen.
Failure conscious. Hello?
Not failure conscious, but. Sorry. Not failure conscious, but forgiven conscious.
So, in case we missed it, God wants you and I to know, to remember. Because of what His Son did, the sins of the world. He knows our past, present, and future sins. He knows all of that. That's why we have the Holy Communion in remembrance, not as a ritual, but in remembrance of what Jesus has done for us. So if you are suffering from some guilt and condemnation of the past mistakes that you have done, today is your day of deliverance. I believe that with all of my heart as we meditate on these scriptures. Does it mean that when we have seen Christ has to die again? No. All of us are now covered under the blood if you have Christ within. Amen?
Amen.
So when you fall short, don't be conscious of that failure, of that sin, but instead of feeling condemned, be conscious of who you are in Christ. Entertain what the Holy Spirit, which by the way will remind you of the scriptures. The role of the Holy Spirit is to remind you who you are in Christ. In Christ, you are totally forgiven. The devil, the thief, remember, he's here to steal, to kill, to destroy us. He's there to remind you of our mistakes, of your mistakes, your failures. So, who do we entertain? The one who will put us down, or the one who will lift us up? Amen? God knows all our sins, past, present, and future. And as what we have read in Hebrews 8:12, I will be merciful to your unrighteousness, your lowest deeds. I will remember no more. So did God lower His standards? Absolutely no. He is still perfectly holy. Yes, He did remember all our sins 2,000 years ago at the cross. Every sin which we have committed or will commit has been punished to the full in the body of His Son, Jesus Christ, at the cross. That's why today Ephesians 1:6, which supports this claim. To the praise of the glory of His grace by which He made us accepted in the beloved, or if you're a Westerner, in the beloved. Filipinos would pronounce it beloved. I'm multi-ethnic. By the way, my first name, Rainier, is French. My last name is Dela Fuente, Spanish. Born in Manila, living in California. So I'm multi-ethnic. So I pronounce it beloved. Okay, the Bible tells us that God has made us accepted in the beloved. Beloved here refers to Jesus, and the word accepted means given special honor or highly favored. So because you have been received, you have received Jesus, who is God's beloved, and you are found in Him, you are also His beloved son or daughter. Deeply loved and highly favored. Now, because you are deeply loved and highly favored by God in the beloved, in Jesus, you can expect good things to happen. Expect divine protection. Expect every need to be met by the one who highly favors you. Expect good because you are precious. You are treasured. You are valuable. You are important in His eyes. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Now, Colossians 1:19-23. This is very challenging for us to really receive, but let's see what the Word of God says here. It's kind of long, but let's read it. For God in all His fullness was pleased to live in Christ, and through Him, God reconciled everything to Himself. He made peace with everything in heaven and on earth by means of Christ's blood on the cross. This includes you who were once far away from God. You were His enemies, separated from Him by your evil thoughts and actions. Yet now He has reconciled you to Himself through the death of Christ in His physical body. As a result, He has brought you into His own presence. And you are holy. That's you. You are holy, blameless. And as you stand before Him without a single fault. In the eyes of God, once you receive Jesus, He doesn't see your faults, your mistakes, your sins. But He sees the blood of His Son covering your mistakes. That's why in the eyes of God, He sees you as holy, blameless, above reproach, without a single fault. I know the Bible says that God is holy, so you need to be holy in order to enter heaven. I agree 100%. But hear me very well. Our holiness is not based on what we do or don't do, but it's because of what Jesus has done for us. If we can make ourselves holy, excuse me, Jesus, I don't need yours before God. Isn't that good news? Isn't His grace amazing? Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Christ, I am justified and righteous. Point number 4. For He made Him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness God in him. Much more than having now been justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. For if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his son, much more having been reconciled, shall we be saved by his life. My friend, righteousness in the new covenant is a gift from God to us through Jesus. Let me repeat it again. Righteousness in the new covenant is a gift from God to us through Jesus Christ. And how do we receive that gift? Through his death on the cross. God made Jesus, who knew no sin, made no sin, did not commit any sin, to become sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. But Brother Rainier, I don't understand. How can I be righteous when I have done wrong? First of all, again, let me explain. Righteousness in the new covenant is a gift. It's not what you do or don't do that makes you righteous. It is what Jesus has done. That's why it's a gift for us to receive. And in Galatians 2:16, let's read Galatians 2:16 after this. Knowing that a man is not justified by the works of the law, but by faith in Jesus Christ, even we have believed in Christ Jesus, that we might be justified by faith in Christ and not by the works of the law. For by the works of the law, no flesh shall be justified. Then Romans 4, 5 and 6 says, but to him who does not work, but believes on him who justifies the ungodly, his faith is accounted for righteousness. Just as David describes the blessedness of the man to whom God imputes righteousness apart from works. That's why the Bible tells us that after Jesus sacrificed at the cross, God imputes, gives us righteousness, not to those who obey the law, but to anyone who believes in his Son. Why is that? Because Jesus took our sins and gave us his righteousness. So at the cross, there was a divine exchange. He took our sins, he gave us his gift of righteousness. That's why today, because of what Jesus Christ has done, we are now the righteousness of God in Christ. We are righteous, just as holy, just as receive these scriptures that blessings are on the head of the righteous. Why? Because their idea, their belief that in order to be righteous, you have to be good, you have to be holy, you have to be blameless. That's why if they made up, let's say today they're okay, they do good, they know that they are right, they're righteous, they're up. They made a mistake, it went down. They heard Pastor Gene preach, they went up. Then go down, then go up. So it's that like when you know that you are righteous by the blood of Christ as a gift, your identity, you know, you can receive, you can believe that scripture is for you. Blessings are on the righteous. That's me. That's you. That's why it's very important for us to know who we are in Christ. That's why other people will not say, this scripture is not for me. Because they have a wrong belief. That's why today, as we study, as we meditate the Word of God and understand who we are in Christ, identity in Christ, we can believe His promises confidently. We can expect good things to happen. Blessings are on the head of the righteous. That's you. So every time you hear, read the Bible saying the righteous, that's you. Receive it, claim it. Lord, I thank you. This scripture is for me. And then rest on His word. Expect good things to happen because you are loved, you are forgiven, you are justified, you are accepted, you are approved, and you are righteous. You don't have to fear coming to God. I know some people have, instead of coming to God when they make mistakes, they shy away from God instead of coming to Him because they're failure conscious, they're sin conscious, instead of forgiven conscious, instead of Christ, instead of failure conscious. But let's be Christ conscious. Let's remember what Jesus has done. It's a blessing for us to receive. Amen. Savior we have in Jesus, right? Do you know it? It's the Lord. Number 5, in Christ I am redeemed and greatly blessed. Ephesians 1:7, in Him we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of His grace. Hebrews 10:14, for by one offering He has perfected forever those who are being sanctified. Is that you and me? Absolutely. Praise be to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. by his stripes we are healed. For I will restore health unto you and heal you of your wounds, says the Lord, in Jeremiah 37. For I am the Lord who heals. How many of you have seen that movie, The Passion of Christ? One of the biggest outcries of that movie was that it was too violent. That was the critic. When in the reality was that it was not violent. The Bible says that at the cross, Jesus' image was marred beyond human condition. There was no beauty that you would desire in him, the Bible says. And he was beaten up until his face looked like a jelly hanging out like smoke. And his bones was exposed while he was being whipped. You know those torture equipment by the Roman soldiers? At the end there were nails. So when the Roman soldier will whip the back of our Savior Jesus, it will. What's in English?
Scorch.
Scorch. So it was scraping his back again. He was glowing. Just imagine. Yes. Jesus was 100% God, but at the same time, when he was on earth, he was 100% man. So imagine the suffering that Jesus was receiving when he was being tortured, when he was being beaten up. What came on him was not the whip stripping the flesh of his bare back, but of the sickness. The chastisement of our peace, for our peace. In the Hebrew original, it's not just peace of mind, but shalom peace, which means wholeness. Our total well-being, spirit, soul, body, was upon our Lord. And the Bible says that by his stripes, we are healed.
shall separate us from the love of Christ shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword, as it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter, yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world. 1 John 4:4. If God's word says we are more than conquerors through Christ who loved us, then we are. We are not trying or going to become, we already are, because his word says so. Amen?
Amen.
And because the one who is in you is greater than he is in you. The moment you accept Jesus as your Lord, your personal Lord and Savior, the new person inside you is more than a conqueror. You are already on victory ground, and you have victory over every challenging situation that you will be facing. Amen?
Amen.
Receive it. Just receive it by faith. I am more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. And the last point, I am a joint heir with Christ. Everyone, let's say that. I am a joint heir with Christ. Romans 8:16-17 says, the Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs of God and heirs with Christ. And if you are in Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. Galatians 4:7 says, therefore you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. And the last scripture, and God raised us with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus. All the scriptures that we have studied today points to who we are in Christ. The Bible says that if we have Jesus in us, we are children of God. And if children, then heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. In other words, what Jesus has, for who Jesus is, so are we, so are you in this world. 1 John 4:17, let's show that to me on that scripture. 1 John 4:17, love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. Is Christ highly favored by God the Father? Yes or no? Is he righteous? Yes or no?
Yes.
Is he deeply loved? Yes or no?
Yes.
So are you in this world. Amen? Anyone is in Christ Jesus, he is a new creation. All things have passed away, behold, new things are new. Yes. And friend, if you are in Christ, this is your true identity. This is who you are. And
Yes, I'm talking to you.
You?
Yes.
It's not that by accident that you're hearing this word, this message. So I'm asking you, as we pray together, pray this prayer with me. In the comfort of your chair, just close your eyes. Everyone, just close your eyes. And just lift your hands. And repeat after me, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you for loving me.
Thank you for loving me.
And accepting me.
And accepting me.
Just as I am.
Just as I am.
A sinner.
A sinner.
Thank you for dying on the cross for me.
Thank you for dying on the cross for me.
Your precious blood has cleansed me from all my sins. Thank you for making me righteous. Holy, blameless, and above reproach before God. I am yours, and you are mine. You are my personal Lord and Savior. Thank you for the gift of eternal life, the peace, the joy, and the blessed assurance